morning. God bless you. We want to welcome everyone who's joining us here and elsewhere. Thank you for being with us. Let's bow our heads. We're going to open with a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord Jesus, for your goodness and your grace. Lord, we ask you for mercy, Lord, and for grace, Lord, as we approach your throne, Lord, and we know you're here. We ask that you would forgive us of our shortcomings and our wherever we fall short of your word, Lord, and we also ask you that you would continue to do the work, Lord Jesus, in each person's life that is within the sound of our voices, Lord Jesus, that as you told us yourself, you are the author and the finisher of our faith, Lord God. And we rest in you, Lord, and we do our part, and then we ask you to do the work, Lord Jesus. And as we approach you today, we ask that you would accept our worship and our praise, not only here, but every day, Lord God, and that we ask you to be with us and join us in the service, Lord. You touch every heart, Lord Jesus, and every mind in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
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 God bless you once again. Let us go and let's start singing songs and praising the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Let us start with victory in Jesus. How many are happy today? Amen. Happy to be here. Amen. Those that are watching online, you feel free to worship. I heard an old story. I heard an old story. How a Savior came from glory. How he gave his life on Calvary. To save a wretch like me, I heard about his groaning, of his precious blood atoning. And then I repented of my sin and won the victory. Oh, victory! And he bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me a new name, and all my love is new to him. He touched me to victory beneath the cleansing blood. I heard about his healing, all his cleansing power revealing. How he made the lame to walk again, and caused the blind to see. And then I cried, dear Jesus, come and heal my broken spirit. And somehow Jesus came and brought to me the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior, forever. He sought me and bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me. He touched me to victory, beneath the cleansing blood. I heard about a mansion he has built for me in glory. And I heard about the streets of gold beyond the crystal sea. About the angels singing and the old redemption story, and some sweet day I'll sing up there the song of victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior, forever. He sought me and he bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me like you did, and all my love is to him. He punched me to victory,
amen. Thank you, Lord.
Let us continue. There shall be showers of blessings. Amen. There shall be showers of blessing. This is the promise of love. There shall be seasons refreshing, sent from the Savior above. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops round us are falling, but for the showers we need. There shall be showers of blessing, precious reviving again. Over the hills and the valley, sound of abundance of rain. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops round us are falling, but for the showers we need. There shall be showers of blessing, send the hearts, O Lord, and grant to us now refreshing. Come and now honor thy word. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing we need. Mercy round us are falling, what for the showers we need. There shall be showers of blessing, all that daily might fall. Now as to love we're confessing, now as on Jesus we call. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops round us are falling, but for the showers we need. Amen. Let's give the Lord a clap offering, yes? Amen. We're going to go to the thanksgivings, the petitions, and the offering. How many are happy to have a thankful Thanksgiving to the Lord? Amen. Those that are watching, if you're thankful for whatever it may be, your blessings, your healing, for the presence of the Lord in your life, the Lord Jesus Christ, I want to say thank you, Lord, for being ever present. We're going to go to the petitions, which I have none right now that are written down, but the Lord knows your heart's desires, needs, and your petitions. If you don't have a petition, take your neighbor, take your loved one, and everybody has a petition when they think of their family. So take your family, whoever it may be, to the Lord in prayer, and He'll answer it. Let us bow our heads as Brother Alex Burunda Jr. comes here and prays for the petitions, thanksgivings, and for those who had also birthdays, God bless you, and for the offering and tithing. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus, we are so thankful, Lord Jesus, for, as our brother Stephen was mentioning, our families, Lord. We have a family throughout the country here in the USA. We have family in the Latin American countries, Lord Jesus, and it's really good to be there and country of Peru, and it's a blessing to see that they're believers out there. And Lord Jesus, we ask you to bless us, Lord Jesus. Open the doors, Lord Jesus. And we thank you for the open doors that are still there, Lord Jesus. And you're the one who opens them and closes them, so we can only hang on to you and go to thee, Lord Jesus, because you know all we're trying to do here, Lord Jesus. We ask you to bless everyone, heal everybody, Lord. Everybody that's sick, everyone that's sick, whatever part of the body that's ailing them, Lord Jesus, we thank you for the sacrifice on Calvary that you made. We can only go back to the blood of Jesus Christ, which cleanses us of every sin and also heals our bodies. Lord Jesus, you said in the Old Testament, you're our God that heals, that takes away our iniquities, forgives our iniquities, and heals our diseases. And we're thankful for that. And that's what we claim today, that you're not changing. You're a real God. You keep your word. And that's all we got, Lord, just to go to you this morning. And whatever it is on the body, Lord, heal it, Lord Jesus, at this moment, Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus, as we know that we're a triune being, Lord Jesus, there's a spirit, Lord Jesus. Our spirit needs to be healed also, Lord God.
Yes.
Anointed, Lord Jesus, and deep down in the soul, Lord Jesus, where we make those decisions, those predestinated decisions. But you're so grateful and so good to us, Lord Jesus. You gave us the free will to make our decision. And we make a decision this morning that we cannot go back. We want to go forward and serve you.
Yeah.
And Lord, we believe your word, and we bank on that, Lord Jesus. And we hang on to that. And we grab and hold on to that, Lord Jesus. And we ask you this morning to also bless the tithing and the offering. We thank you and praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. If you'd like to stand for a little bit, and you may stretch your legs, but let us sing, When I See the Blood. Amen. Christ our Redeemer died on the cross and died for the sinner. He offered you the spirit for your soul with the blood of the Lamb. Jesus will save all he has promised, that will he do. Oh, wash in the fountain, open for sin, and I will pass over you. Oh, when I see the blood, oh, great compassion, oh, boundless love, oh, loving kindness, faithful and true, find peace and shelter under the blood, and I will pass the valley over you. Oh, when I see the blood, when I see the blood.
Says wherever two or three are gathered in his name, he is in the midst. We would like to thank God for his word, and now we're going to hear from him, and we're only going to be an echo, and we like to just prepare our hearts. And those that are watching, we pray that the Lord will help you and whatever your needs may be. Let us prepare and let's see amazing grace where we prepare ourselves to hear the word. Amen. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that sings. Precious Heavenly Father, Lord, we come before you, Lord Jesus. Lord, I acknowledge myself, Lord, that there is nothing good in me, Lord Jesus. It is all about you, Lord Jesus. Lord, I'd like to thank you for the grace that you shed upon my life, Lord Jesus, and the mercy, the abundance of mercy and grace. For each and every one that is listening, that is here, that you have given them, Lord. Truly, you are the fountain of mercy, grace, love, and you are still flowing, willing to give the heart's needs and the heart's desires according to your word, Lord Jesus. You are a fountain and you're still flowing, and out from you is still flowing eternal life, Lord Jesus. We ask that you break the bread of life, Lord Jesus, and
May each and every one of us take of it and eat, Lord, and be strengthened and given energy, Lord, to be refreshed, Lord Jesus, by your Holy Spirit, Lord, and helping us in these days, Lord Jesus. We ask that you heal the people, heal each and every one of us, Lord. Lord, we know that you healing is a process, Lord Jesus, but take us through this process, Lord, and show us, Lord, how merciful you are, Lord. And just let us feel your tender mercy touch each and every one of our parts of our body that needs to be healed, Lord. Our spirit, our mind, our body, Lord, and our soul, Lord. Heal us, touch us, refresh us, Lord, once again, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. You may be seated. Those that are watching online, we would like to say God bless you. We're going to continue to talk about God's program. This thought, I believe it didn't come from the enemy, but I know it had to come from somewhere. So I'd like to thank the Lord for God's program. Subtitles is to lead his people by his Holy Spirit. God's program is to lead us by his Holy Spirit. I'd like just to bring to remembrance how, like Simeon from in the Bible, how he was told by the Holy Ghost that he would not see death. And I have it here in Luke chapter 2:25. I don't have it there. And behold, there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. And the same man was just and devout, waiting for the consolation of Israel. And the Holy Ghost was upon him. And it was revealed unto him by the Holy Ghost that he should not see death before he had seen the Lord's Christ. And he came by the Spirit into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him after the custom of the law, then took he him up in his arms and blessed God and said, Lord, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace according to thy word. For mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, a light to lighten the Gentiles and the glory of the people of Israel. Amen. I like how he said right there first, a light to lighten the Gentiles first. That is something in itself that is beautiful. And the glory of the people of Israel. I believe it was placed perfectly in order. How perfect the Holy Spirit is. God's program is not only to lead, but to guide his church. To lead us to all truth. His program is for us to believe in signs and wonders. God's program is to separate and to divide. These are just little thoughts that came to me. And I know we read that. I thought of reading that scripture of an example. But the scripture we were going to go off of truly is Revelation chapter 2. This is his program. I'm just talking about what God's program is. And his program is for us to believe in signs and wonders. God's program is to separate and to divide. God's program is to sustain, feed, heal, forgive, redeem, restore, impart his life to those that believe and foreknew before the foundation of the world, that would walk in his program. Those who refuse to walk in the program of God, they perished. And the same for it today. Those were just a little bit of thoughts. But the main scripture, if you would like, we can stand for that one. All scripture we should stand, but I said it in that manner. So God's program number four, to lead his people by his Holy Spirit. Let's go to Revelation chapter 2, verse 1. We'll read the first two verses. We'll take it slow, take my time, and then you can sit down. It says, unto the angel of the church of Ephesus write, these things saith he that holdeth the seven stars in his right hand, who walketh in the midst of the seven golden candlesticks. I know thy works, and thy labor, and thy patience, and how thou canst not bear them which are evil, and thou hast tried them which say they are apostles and are not, and hast found them liars. You may be seated. I have put some scripture here, and we're going to continue to read in Revelations. Just that word that says how I've tried, and we were told in John chapter, 1 John chapter 4, verse 1 through 4, as beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits, whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. And that goes with the scripture that says, they have tried. How are you tried? You tried them by the word and by the spirit. Matthew 24:24, it also talks about that. We're going to go ahead and continue, and I'm going to stick to my slides. And has borne and has patience, and for my name's sake has labored and has not fainted. Nevertheless, I have somewhat against thee, because thou hast left thy first love.
Yes.
Remember therefore from whence thou art fallen, and repent, and do the first works, or else I will come unto thee quickly, and will remove thy candlestick out of his place, except you repent. But this thou hast, that thou hatest the deeds of the Nicolaitans, which I also hate. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. To him that overcometh will I give to eat of the tree of life, and which is in the midst of the paradise of God.
Amen.
Amen. How many times, if those who have read it, it says, how many times did God repeat himself? He that hath an ear. Mm-hmm. He that hath an ear. Hear what the Spirit is saying. So the Spirit is speaking, and the Spirit of God is crying out. That's just beautiful. It says, hear what the Spirit, he that hath an ear, not all that they have ears. Everybody has ears, but not everybody are going to hear. It takes a special ear. we're going to continue to talk. God's program number four, to lead his people by his Holy Spirit. Scriptures, Hebrews 13:8, Jesus Christ the same yesterday and today and forever. Let's continue to read some scriptures here, and then we'll get into. And I know how the brothers would say, well, that sounds like cliche. Everybody uses that word. It's the word of God, and if we're gonna see if he's the same yesterday, today, and forever, then we're going to go back into the scriptures of yesterday, the Old Testament, bring it for today, and then how he says, my word shall never fail. And let every man's word be a lie, but my words will never fail. Ecclesiastes 3:14. I know that whatsoever God doeth, it shall be forever. Nothing can be put to it, nor anything taken from it. And God doeth it that men should fear before him. I know that whatsoever God doeth, it shall be forever. Nothing can be put to it, nor anything taken from it. And God doeth it that men should fear before him. Ecclesiastes 3:15. That which hath been is now, and that which is to be hath already been. And God required that which is past. Revelations 22. Huh, it stopped on me again. I don't know. We may just hit all our slides there. Man, Revelations 22:18. Thank you. Your phone, thank you. For I testify unto every man that heareth the words of the prophecy. Heareth. Amen. For I testify unto every man that heareth the words of the prophecy of this book, if any man shall add unto these things, God shall add unto him the plagues that are written in this book. And if any man shall take away from the words of the book of this prophecy, God shall take away his part out of the book of life, and out of the holy city, and from the things which are written in this book. Just before we get into the slides, I think I said this last time, or I heard it, whatever it may be, but some people believe that the Antichrist is just only against the Word of God, is to be against. But as we read right here, not only is it to be against it, but it's to take from the book, take from the Word, and to add to the Word. That is also being an Antichrist. So if somebody is taking away from the Word and adding their own doctrine and creed, what is that? An exposition of the seven church ages. What are these Nicolaitans? The word comes from two Greek words. Niko, which means to conquer, and Laos, which means laity. In plain fact, somebody was doing something in the early church which was conquering the laity. If the laity were being conquered, then it must have been some authority there doing it. What was it that God hated that was happening in the church, which we had just read in Revelation chapter 2? What was going on then, and is going on today, is exactly what the word Nicolaitan means. The people were being subjected somehow in a way that was absolutely contrary to the word of God. Now, to get the real meaning of what we are about to go into, I must caution you to ever keep in mind that religion, spiritual matters, if you like, is composed of two parts that intertwine but are as opposite as black and white. Amen. We'll find out. There's nothing new. It's just being an echo and repeating slowly, so that those that are online, not those that are here, these are for those that are online, that can read and hear it and see it. And that's why I'm going slow. Okay? It'll also help those that are just barely tuned in to see where you're at. I mean, we all want to come to church to be better and never leave the same, but to go out different and equipped, strengthened for what is coming and what is going on, and what the Lord wants us to know. Religion and the spiritual world are made of those two trees which had their roots in Eden. Both the tree of life and the tree of knowledge of good and evil, stood in the midst of the garden. And no doubt their very branches intertwined each other. Thus, in the Ephesian church, is that same paradox. The church is made up of good and bad.
Wow.
Here's something that will help those in their also their life too. Some still haven't realized that that same battle is not only in the church, but that is within our bodies also.
Wow.
Because in the garden of back in the garden, how the enemy had injected his DNA, his nature, and intertwined into our very bodies. So very body, even the Apostle Paul had spoke about this. It says, when I want to do good, I find out that evil is present. That I should do, I do not do. But what I want to do, I don't do it. And what I shouldn't do, I do it. So within my body, there are two natures. There are two things. That whatever I want to do good, bad is always present. So not only in our own bodies, it is also in the church too. It says it is he has intertwined not only into our physical beings, that we would have this battle continually into the day that we go.
Yes.
That's why God's program, he laid a program for each and every one of us, that he knew what would happen and that we would walk in his program, and he would take care of all things. But as we reject his program and walk in our own way,
amen,
then we go to our end, and our expected end is not to be back with him. So we find out here that also that they, if you just want to read, there was just too many scriptures. I'm going to stick to the slides. You go and figure it out. You go to read the book in Genesis and how the evil one interjected himself into the DNA, into the human race. And then here came Abel and then Cain. They had two churches there. One was a spiritual revelation of Abel. He came and gave a sacrifice and shed blood of a lamb. That's what was required by a spiritual revelation. And Cain came, he made his altar. So he had his own church. He made it beautiful of the fruit of the ground. And he gave the best what he had thought what was required. But he had forgot, and I don't think he even paid attention when God, he said, cursed be the ground for your sake, Adam. He cursed the ground. So he brought everything from the ground that was grew up, and all the fruits, and tried to offer it to God. God could not accept what he had cursed. So if those would help.
Yes.
And no doubt their very branches intertwine each other. Thus, in Ephesian church, is that same paradox. The church is made up of good and bad. Two vines make the church. They are like the wheat and tares, growing up side by side. But one is true and the other is false. Now God will speak to each one, and he will talk about each one. He will call them church, and only the elect will really know which is the true spirit. Only the elect will not be deceived, as the scripture says, Matthew 24:24. For there shall arise false Christs and false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders, insomuch that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect. So way back there in the early church, a very short period after Pentecost, the false vine got to intertwine itself around the true vine. And we find these deeds of the Nicolaitans. And that spirit is going to be found fighting the true vine until it is destroyed by God,
Now have you got it? All right. Now, what was the spiritual climate of that church? It had left its first love. Leaving its first love of the Word of God was revealed to us as have fallen from its origin, which was Pentecost. In plain English, that means this church was in danger of being taken away from the leading of the Holy Spirit, the control of the Spirit. This was exactly what took place after Moses led Israel out of Egypt. Later, I want to get you to those who have their Bibles, to Numbers chapter 16. I didn't put it all on a slide, but this will help bring more light to those that are watching, so you understand. Okay, nobody here. In plain English, that means that the church was in danger of being taken away from the leading of the Holy Spirit and control of the Spirit. This was exactly what took place after Moses led Israel out of Egypt. The way of God was to lead them by the cloud of fire, prophetic utterance, miracles and signs, and God-given wonders. This was to be accomplished by God selected and God ordained and God equipped and God sent men, with the whole camp being dominated by a Holy Ghost move. Man. They rebelled and wanted to set rules and creeds to go by. Then they wanted a king.
Wow. That's right.
So do we see it how it's happening here now? I'm gonna stick to the signs and wonders, the pillar of fire, the cloud. Then they wanted to be exactly like the world. And went into complete apostasy and oblivion. Apostasy. Renunciation, abandonment of neglect and established religion. You could also read that with the late, and from the Greek. But revolt, defection, literally, and standing off, to stand away. Oblivion, state of fact of forgetting and forgetfulness, a loss of memory. I did that because if I wanted to know, man, I know there's somebody else wanted to know. I wanted to make sure that's exactly what I had imagined or had understood. That is exactly how the first church age started. And it will get worse and worse until the Holy Spirit is completely rejected. And God must destroy the people. I know there's not much to smile about that, but that's exactly true. That we go into the world right now, they have completely gone insane, rejected all of the Word of God, and not only the Word of God, but the Spirit, and man in the Spirit is crying out, repent, go back to your first works, go back to the Word of God, and they continue to make their own word, their own dogmas and creeds, to fashion the Word of God, supposing to make their own word to fit the conditions of today. God's program number four, to lead his people by his Holy Spirit. Revelation 2:11. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. He that overcometh shall not be hurt of the second death. So the Spirit of God continues to cry out, he that hath an ear, And usually when you hear something, you start to, your attention starts to turn, you start to wake up what the Spirit is trying to say. If the Spirit is saying, you don't have to change, just come and shake my hand, put your name on a book, get this Bible that's made for the times. I don't know if I mentioned this right now, but I found out that Walt Disney, I believe it was Walt Disney, they bought the rights of the, I believe it's the NIV. I believe it's the NIV Bible. That's the new translation or new translation of the Bible. And they're changing it. And they're taking this out. They're taking all the scriptures that say about effeminate and homosexuality and the sin, and they're inputting certain their words to make it, oh, you really don't have to repent. Oh, he didn't talk about this. He didn't talk about against that. So that is completely antichrist, to change the word. But I thank God for the New King James Version, and that's why I came to this point when it says, I have hid thy word in my heart. And even if they were to take the books away, you have it in you, amen, in your heart. They can't take that away. Amen. You know what's right, and yes, you know what's wrong.
Yes,
and you know what he has imprinted on your heart.
Yes.
We become books, epistles to the world, written of God, read of man, written of God. Amen. We also know that Satan also has done that too. Therefore, we ought to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard. He that hath an ear, hear what the Spirit is saying.
Wow.
Therefore, we ought to give more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest any time we should let them slip.
Yes.
Huh? What did you say? Huh? Oh, I remember you said that. He that hath an ear, wake up. What is the Spirit telling you? You are hearing it right now from the pure, unadulterated word from God. The King James Bible is saying, he that hath an ear, go back, do your first works.
Yes.
And if you didn't do your first works, well, this is your chance. Repent. It says repent. Be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins. Repent. Followed by baptism, showing that there was a genuine repentance within your heart. And that you want to go to the waters and be baptized for the remission, meaning that they've been forgiven. Now, by being baptized, they are sent away.
Yes.
Back to the one, to the originator of sin.
Yes, sir.
You no longer bear those sins. You no longer even remember those sins because God has taken them and put them into the sea of forgetfulness.
Yes,
that's how beautiful God is. I have blotted out thy iniquities and thy transgressions and thy sins, and I shall remember them no more. But the only one who remembers them is the devil himself, because he comes to us day and night.
Yes.
Day and night.
Uh-huh.
Every day.
Uh-huh.
This is what you did. You're good for nothing.
Right.
How could you say God loves you? Look at this. Nobody loves you. Look what you did. Mm. But you know what? I love you. What a lie of the devil. He loves to take you to hell. That's what he wants to do. He wants to rob your God-given right and your experience to have fellowship with God. He wants to take that away from you. You have a God-given right to come to him, to know what love is, to know what accepting is, but it's in his provided way. God provided a way for each and every one of us. That's why it says, he that hath an ear, hear what the Spirit is saying. There's two spirits that are speaking right now. There's one that is good, and there's one that is bad. That's why, this is awesome. Therefore, we ought to give more earnest heed. Listen to that spirit, what the Spirit, the good Holy Spirit, what the Word of God is speaking. And if someone in their right mind, you just do the contrast of it. You want to live, have eternal life? The one is telling me, come this way. The other one is telling me, I'll give you life, but the end is hell and death, corruption into your flesh. things which we have heard, lest at any time we should let them slip. For if the word spoken by angels was steadfast, and every transgression and disobedience received a just recompense of reward. Mm-hmm. Yeah. How shall we escape if we neglect so great salvation, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord, and was confirmed unto us by them that heard him? God also bearing them witness both with signs and wonders, and with diverse miracles and gifts of the Holy Ghost, according to his own will. If you want, you can have your Bibles ready to, we're going to read something in Numbers chapter 16. And we're going to read in Acts chapter 1, verse 1. The former treatise have I made, O Theophilus, of all that Jesus began to both do and teach, until the day which he was taken up. After that, he, through the Holy Ghost, had given commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen. Now, Numbers chapter 16. I only put a few slides, but I believe this would be very good. And then we're going to find out how this also happened in the wilderness. I put, now, Korah and the son of Izhar, and the son of Kohath, the son of Levi, and Dathan and Abiram, the sons of Eliab, and On, the son of Peleth, sons of Reuben, took men. Now, I want to stop right there. Korah, Dathan, Abiram, these weren't Egyptians. These weren't Egyptians. After reading this, I was like, oh my goodness. Korah was the son of Levi. And the Levites were chosen by God.
Yes.
To do the ministering,
uh-huh,
in the congregation. Dathan and Abiram were sons of Reuben, of the tribe of Israel. Took men, and they rose up before Moses with certain of the children of Israel, talking about rebellion, Nicolaitan, 250 princes of the assembly, famous in the congregation,
wow,
men of renown, and they gathered themselves together against Moses and against Aaron, and said unto them, ye take too much upon you, seeing all the congregation are holy, every one of them, and the Lord is among them. Therefore then lift ye up yourselves above the congregation of the Lord. I want to, let's continue reading on this. This is, it gets gooder and gooder. So those have never read it and don't understand, when does Nicolaitan also happen? The conquering laity, it happened in the wilderness also. Now, follow me now. Chapter 16, Numbers, verse 4. And when Moses heard it, he fell upon his face, and he spake unto Korah and unto all his company, saying, even tomorrow the Lord will show who are his and who is holy, and will cause him to come near unto him. Even him whom he hath chosen will he cause to come near unto him. Verse 6. This do, take you take you censers, Korah and all his company, and put fire therein, and put incense in them before the Lord tomorrow. And it shall be that the man whom the Lord doth choose, he shall be holy. Ye take too much upon you, you sons of Levi. And Moses said unto Korah, hear, I pray you, you sons of Levi. This is awesome right now. He's telling them, they interjected themselves and said, we are holy ones. So he says, go take the censers, fill it with fire, and because that was the duty of the Levi, to fill the censer with fire and put incense and burn incense before the Lord, representing the prayers of the saints and being able to approach God. Seemeth it put a small thing unto you that God of Israel hath separated you from the congregation of Israel to bring you near to himself to do service of the tabernacle of the Lord and to stand before the congregation to minister unto them. And he hath brought thee near to him and all the brethren, the sons of Levi, with thee. And seek ye the priesthood also? You hear that question? You also seek the priesthood also? For which cause both thou and all the company are gathered together against the Lord. And what is Aaron that ye murmur against him? Did you read that in verse 11? Did you see how they thought they were going to do a service to the Lord, but they came against the Lord? And Moses sent to call Dathan and Abiram and sons of Eleb, which said, we will not come up. It is a small thing that thou hast brought us up out of the land that floweth with milk and honey to kill us in the wilderness, except thou make thyself altogether a prince over us. Moreover, thou hast not brought us into a land that floweth with milk and honey, or given us an inheritance of the fields and vineyards. Wilt thou put out the eyes of these men? We will not come up. And Moses was very wroth and said unto the Lord, respect not thou their offering. I have not taken one ass from them, neither have I hurt one of them. And Moses said unto Korah, be thou and all thy company before the Lord, thou and they and Aaron tomorrow, and take every man his censer and put incense in them, and bring ye before the Lord every man his censer, 250 censers, thou also and Aaron each of you his censer. And they took every man his censer and put fire in them and laid incense thereon and stood in the door of the tabernacle of the congregation with Moses and Aaron. Verse 19, and Korah gathered all the congregation against them unto the door of the tabernacle of the congregation. And the glory of the Lord appeared unto all the congregation. And the Lord spake unto Moses and unto Aaron, saying, separate yourselves from among the congregation, that I may consume them in a moment. And they fell upon their faces and said, O God, the God of the spirits of all flesh, shall one man sin, and wilt thou be wroth with all the congregation? And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto the congregation, saying, get ye up from about the tabernacle of Korah and Dathan and Abiram. And Moses rose up and went unto Dathan and Abiram, and the elders of Israel followed him. And he spake unto the congregation, saying, depart, I pray you, from the tents of this wicked men, and touch nothing of theirs, lest ye be consumed in all their sins. So they gat up from the tabernacle of Korah, Dathan, Abiram, in every side, and Dathan and Abiram came out and stood in the door of their tents, and their wives and their sons and their little children. And Moses said, Hereby ye shall know that the Lord hath sent me to do all these works. For I have not done them of my own mind. If these men die the common death of all men, or if they be visited after the visitation of all men, then the Lord hath not sent me. Verse 30. But if the Lord make a new thing, and earth open her mouth, and swallow them up, with all the apparition unto them, and they go down quick into the pit, then ye shall understand that this men have provoked the Lord. And it came to pass, as he had made an end of speaking all these words, that the ground clave asunder that was under them, and the earth opened her mouth and swallowed them up, and their houses, and all the men that appertained unto Korah, and all their goods. They and all that appertained to them went down alive into the pit, and the earth closed up them, and they perished from among the congregation. And all Israel that were around about them fled at the cry of them, for they said, lest the earth swallow us up also. And there came out a fire from the Lord and consumed the 250 men that offered incense. You don't mind reading, do you? And Israel that were around about them fled and cried of them, for they said, lest the earth swallow us up also. And there came out a fire from the Lord and consumed the 250 men and offered incense. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, now 37, speak unto Eleazar the son of Aaron the priest, and that they take up the censers out of the burning, and scatter thou the fire yonder, for they are hallowed. And even their sacrifices, the incense, he said, toss them out, for they misuse the censers. The censers of these sinners against their own souls, let them make them broad plates for the covering of the altar, for they offer them before the Lord. Therefore they are hallowed, and they shall be a sign unto the children of Israel. And this is also over here, we're going to stop right there. Also in this scripture, if you continue to read in this chapter, that not only did he do away with the 250, but there was also 14,000 more that he was about to give them a plague for them actually speaking out. And when Moses heard, he says, a plague is going to drop. He says, I'm going to consume them, Moses. He told in the Spirit of God in Moses, cried out, he said, Aaron, put fire on it, on the censer. Put incense. Run and make an atonement for the children of Israel, because God had it with them. Even after he consumed the 250, he was going to slay all of Israel. Most of Israel. He dropped the plague. A plague is happening. Moses saw it before him. The plague is happening. People, boom, boom, started dropping dead like flies. He told his brother Aaron, make an atonement. Run, hurry, fast. For the children of Israel. And as soon as he did that, he ran before the congregation with the censer and the incense. Can you believe the Spirit of God upon them? Wouldn't you have said, let them? They made their own bed. Let them lay in it. They sown to the wind. Let them reap the whirlwind. But the Spirit of God, he says, no, no, make an atonement. So he ran there and slayed the lamb, applied the blood, making an atonement before God. And as he made the atonement, the plague ceased.
Amen.
Saved the children of Israel, and only 14,000 plus the 250 were slain and consumed. He said, what has this got to do? What are you talking about, man? He says, everything. How the Nicolaitan tried to arise, that came up, tried to take over, the move of God. Israel was not called the church until they came out of Egypt. Wow. Then when they were in Egypt, on their journey, he dealt with them as a church. Yes. Now do you see how the church, he that hath an ear, hear what the Spirit says? They both were there. They were both intertwined. Mm-hmm. The good and the bad.
Yes, yes.
The true and the false.
Mm-hmm. I'll be closing right now. I have 30 seconds.
Moses. Moses was herding his father-in-law's sheep, Jethro, on the backside of the desert. And one day, an angel appeared to him in a burning bush. Now, an angel came down to bring the message to Moses, and otherwise was to be his guide. Men are, they can't. You can't guide yourself.
That's right.
There are two ways. That's your way.
That's it.
And God's way.
Thank you, Lord.
And when you're in your way, you're out of God's way. You're out of God's program. It's not your program. It's God's program. It is God's word. It is not your word. I'm not speaking my word. I'm speaking His word. I'm only echoing exactly what has been spoken already and what has been written. There are only two ways. That's your way and God's way. You remember that saying when you're in your mom or dad's house and you want to do things your way? You know how when mom and dad says, you know, there's only two ways here, okay? It's my way and it's not your way. But your way is going to get you on your own highway, because you're not walking to the beat of the drum. And the beat of the drum is this, this for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord. That's what the law has been laid down. I didn't lay it down, but the Lord laid it down. And that's what I walk in. And if you're not walking that way, it says, I'll tell you one thing. I was never kicked out of my house. But because I wanted to walk my way and do the things my way, I left the house. When my mom and dad were, actually my dad says, Esteban, as long as you're in this house, you cannot do the things that you are doing. That's all he said. He didn't say, pack your bags and hit the road. He just told me, the things that you are doing. Why? Because the things of the world, that's what I was doing. I was coming to the house all messed up. All drunk, all high. This is for those. He didn't kick me out, but because I wanted to do what I wanted to do, I left the house. But if I were to walk in the way that was put, I would never have gone through those things. Yes, God will forgive you when you come into your right mind.
Wow.
He will forgive you.
Wow.
He will also even heal you. But the thing is that you will pay the price for every single thing that you have done wrong.
Yes.
Amen.
Oh. You will pay it in the flesh. You will pay it in the spirit.
Amen.
And you will even be tormented of your soul.
Amen.
But He will forgive you.
Amen.
Isn't that awesome? But why will you want to go do that? That's why I'm going to ask those, why do you want to punish yourself? Why do you want to kill your body? Why do you want to prostitute your flesh, your health? You give yourself to the devil who wants to chew you up like a piece of gum and spit you out. And then you're good for nothing. You're lower than the gum that people scrape off of their shoes. That's what the devil wants you to think. But within each and every one of us is a soul that is... there's no price to it.
Amen.
You cannot put a price to it. It is worth more than 10,000 worlds. But we give ourselves to the enemy. Those that are watching, give yourself to the Lord in your youth. Give yourself
all your strength. Man. Give it to the Lord. Yes, work for Him. Do it for Him. Be a light unto the world. Man. So people that are doing the things, you can put a bone in your nose, you can make your ears so big, you can put a basketball on it. But why would you want to do that? God will forgive you, yes, but you will pay the price.
That's right.
You will have the scars. Your ears will look like horse stirrups. You can't fix them after you take them out, after you wake up, after you take the bone out of your nose, all the piercings in your lip and looking like a demonized character. You're only expressing what spirit has got you, only what spirit that is projecting through you. He that hath an ear, hear what the Spirit is saying to you. There are two ways. That's your way and God's way. And when you're in your own way, you're out of God's way.
Yes, sir.
And you have to forget your own way to find God's way. The man cannot lead himself. A woman cannot lead herself.
No.
I know we're always speaking about man. But here we go, woman. You cannot lead yourself. He was called a sheep. We're likened to sheep, as helpless as can be. Can't find our way around. Don't know what to eat. Don't know where to walk. That's why we need a shepherd. Jesus Christ, our shepherd. If there's anybody around here knows anything about raising sheep, when a sheep gets lost, it's perfectly helpless. It'll just stand there and bleat till it dies. That's all. It's helpless. We got a possible sheep out there that's standing out there lost. He doesn't know where to go, doesn't know where to ask for help.
Yes, sir.
And we, without a leader, are helpless. And Christ is our leader. And God was Moses' leader. Though he sent an angel to lead him, I send my angel before thee to keep thee in the way, and to bring thee to the place which I have promised. The angel was to be his leader. To the angel of the church of Ephesus, I say. He starts to every church age. To the angel. Let us stand. The angel performed the miracles. Moses never performed any miracle. The angel of God in Moses performed the miracle. You see what I mean? The angel of the Lord was with him. The angel led them, performed the miracles. Let us bow our heads. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for thy love and mercy, Lord Jesus. We thank you for these words, Lord. We thank you for your word. Lord, hopefully it has helped them, Lord Jesus. It helped me, Lord Jesus. It was good for the goose, it's good for the gander, Lord Jesus. It gets gooder and gooder. Lord, continue to help us, Lord. We know that you're with us, for your word says, I will be with you, even in you, into the day of your redemption. Lord, if somebody can't say or testify, and say that I know the Lord Jesus Christ is in me. Lord, at this very moment, Lord Jesus, if they raise their hands, those that are watching online, say, Lord, I surrender myself right now to you, Lord Jesus. Fill me with your Holy Spirit, Lord Jesus. Come to me and dwell inside my heart. Change me, fill me, Lord. Send me a light to those that are in darkness, Lord Jesus, no matter who they may be, woman, man. Lord, there's a work to be done, Lord Jesus. All according to thy word, Lord Jesus. Give strength to the women, for their children, for their family, for their household, Lord. Lord, ignite those hearts of men, creating them a powerful light, Lord Jesus, a beacon of light in a time of darkness, Lord Jesus, to testify of the power of Almighty God. Lord Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for your love and kindness. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, amen. You may be seated and let us we'll continue with this later. Lord willing, I'm learning to say that Lord willing. If the Lord is willing, we'll continue with this. How many can give a clap offering to the Lord? Can we give a clap offering to the Lord? Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. At the cross. At last ended my Savior bleed, and in my sovereign night would he be without that hatred for such a worm as I. At the cross, where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Was it for Christ that I have done? He brought upon the tree. Cherish the old rugged cross on a hill far away, on
I love you.
Touch those and strengthen Brother Gilbert and Yanez and Sister Juanita and Nagadoches and those that are congregating, Lord Jesus. May your Holy Spirit continue to strengthen them and bless them, Lord Jesus. Bless your work there, Lord Jesus, and wherever you are working, Lord Jesus. We ask all things in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you. Amen. Let us sing. It's not on there, and I'm just going, let's sing Wonderful. I think it's so beautiful just to say Wonderful. It'll be in G. Let's start with the chorus. Wonderful, wonderful, Jesus is to me. And you're dismissed. Counselor, Prince of Peace, my God is He for saving me, keeping me from all sin and shame. Wonderful is my Redeemer, praise His name. Oh, my heart sings.